Hi, I'm Mark Hartley.
And I'm Jasmine George, and now
it's game time.
All right, welcome back, everyone, and thank you for joining us here on Game Time. We're channeling the local sports force here from the IE Media Studio here in downtown San Bernardino. And tonight, here to help us channel that force, in for Caitlin Eaton, no other than Mr. Mark Hartley.
Woo!
How are you doing, Mark?
Jasmine, I'm awesome. Thanks for having me. So happy to be back here on the Game Time set. Hey, we are going to be channeling the local sports force tonight. We're starting with San Bernardino High School's football coach, Monica. So we got to see what some of his players have to say, and we're going to get into the season this year. We're going to talk to some of these outstanding student athletes and make it happen.
That's right. Sounds good. And of course, we're going to be having our student athlete profiles, which will be coming to us from Rialto High School this week. But first, ladies and gentlemen, last week you were introduced to the one and only Corey Sandoval right here in our set of Game Time. And now it's time for Corey Sandoval's sightings throughout the San Andreas League. Now, Corey said he was going to be everywhere. Let's see, how did he do it?
Hey, everyone. I'm Corey Sandoval, and you're not. I'm here at San Gregorio High School between a heated tennis matchup between San G and Ramona High School. Looks to be a good one. I'm here with some dedicated and loyal parents. And who are you guys here for?
We're here to watch our daughter Amy play tennis.
Nice. Amy's actually in a heated matchup right now. Nice forearm swing, Amy. Ramona ends up defeating San G. It was a tough matchup, but they pulled ahead. Now, don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Twitter at GameTimeSB. Unfortunately, I got some bad news. I got cursed while I was here. I don't know how it happened, but every time that I get hit by a ball, I have to go to my next location, even if I don't want to go. No matter what happens, if I want to stay here, I have to just, oh no! I hate this teleportation thing. Oh, glad my headband's gone. Where am I?
San G!
Oh, I made it to my location! Woo! Where did I get these pom-poms from?
From me.
Whoa, thank you, there you go. Well, I'm here at San G at my next location. It's gonna be a great matchup. This is the matchup of the week! We got Rev playing San G. Looks to be a great one. Game's about to start. Whoa, look at this guy. We got a Spartan warrior in the house. Hey, what's your name?
Cody.
Leonidas.
Oh, yeah.
Nice to meet you, Leonidas. Are you ready to go?
Yeah.
You pumped?
Yep.
You guys pumped?
Yeah!
All right. Well, the game's about to kick off, so let's get to it. It's a tough game for San G. Rev ended up winning 35-0. But on a positive note for San G, the Spartan quarterback, number 10, off-field, he had some big plays. He had a nice 19-yard pass, and he had some big runs. Those were pretty impressive. Also, number 3, Snowden, he had some big plays. Back-to-back big yard runs. That was also pretty impressive. The defense played really well for San G tonight. Even though the score was a little one-sided, the defense played really well. Number 20, he had the safety for San G had a huge, vicious hit on one of the Wildcat receivers. It was pretty intense. And also, number 58, Sims, he had a nice interception. It was a pretty good game overall. Unfortunately, the Spartans couldn't come away with the victory.
Thanks, Corey. It looks like you had a lot of fun. We'll see you next week.
Yeah, that was great. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to have the Coach's Corner here in a few minutes. So stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with the Coach's Corner.
How do I love? Well, let me see.
I love you like a lyric loves a melody. How do I need you? Well, can't you tell? I need you like a penny needs a wishing well, baby. Completely wrapped up in you.
Welcome back to Game Time as we channel the local sports force. And you were just watching on TV, Coach from San Bernardino, Coach Monica, and we're happy to have him here on set on Game Time. How are you doing, Coach?
Great, thanks for having me.
Well, thank you for being here. Let's learn more about you and tell us about your coaching background.
Well, this is actually my first job as a coach. I started at San Bernardino High School in 2001, and I've been the head coach for 5 years now. This is my fifth season, actually.
Tell us a little bit about your coaching philosophy. I know you want to educate your boys on the field and off the field as well. What's the philosophy that you use?
Our philosophy is, well, it's discipline and student-athlete first, and discipline is a shorter version for us is do one best, DWB, and we pretty much all live by it, and it stands for do what you're supposed to do when you're supposed to do it to the best of your ability.
That's great. The whole society can learn a lot from that.
Absolutely.
Boy, that's great.
It works. It's tough, though.
Yeah, I bet. I bet.
You've been with San Bernardino for 5 years. Tell us your favorite part. What's the best part of coaching there?
Just the kids. I mean, waking up every day, going to work there, and the daily grind is a job, and then after school, is when my passion starts, and I see all my kids, and it's a family atmosphere more than football.
The last week was a rough week against Palm Desert and everything, but I as an athlete myself, I know that you can always learn something, even when defeat comes around. What have you taught your players about last week's game, and how are you going forward? What are you looking to do?
Well, simple. We outscored Palm Desert 14-12 in the second half, and we had some really huge plays in the first half that were game breakers, We were at their house, brand new school. I mean, they're older, but they got a brand new facility. It's beautiful, and the crowd. And we started. We had an 85-yard touchdown run by our quarterback. He's here tonight, Khleem, and it got called back. And that was a big momentum shift in the game. They went and scored on the next possession. Wow. We had a couple of touchdowns called back. Then we had a couple that stood. But for the kids back in the past, a lot of kids would have put their heads down, and we just got really rolled up on it. It could have been bad.
Right.
Now, speaking of San Andreas League, league plays next week, and you're going to be playing some powerhouses. How do you feel that you're going to fare against some of your opponents in the San Andreas League?
Well, we take it week by week. We start off with the league champion, Cajon, and they're good. They're returning a lot of players. They're 3-0 right now in preseason. They have a bye week like us for an extra week to prepare. And they made it to the semifinals, unfortunately lost, but they lost to another league opponent, which was Colton, and they won CIF. So there's two teams that are gonna be leaving our league also. So they're gonna wanna win those games too.
Now with Cajon, they are a powerhouse, there's no doubt about it. And we don't want to give away any of your team secrets or anything like that, but what's going to become kind of the strategy that you take on against them?
Well, we're going to just have to play, some hard-nosed football against the guys. They got another KZ over there, and they're quick, they're big, they're strong, they're well-coached. And we're just going to play every player 110% to the best of our ability. And see where it takes us.
There you go. Now, you're an alumni from that place.
Cajon, yeah.
Yeah, so any hard feelings going in there and beating them up?
Class of 2008.
All right. Yeah. Wait a second, I don't know.
I was at Cajon, and we were the same then when I played there. We had 14 league championships in a row and a CIF championship, and it's a great program, man. It's only a few miles away, so we can do the same thing at San Bernardino.
Absolutely.
I got no hard feelings. I want to beat them their last year in our league. I know the kids do. We as a family want to beat them.
And I like this family attitude that you guys all have and coming in there as a family approach and everything. I'm sure you've grown closer to a lot of these players. Now, we're going to get to meet a couple of them in a little bit. Of those that aren't here, who'd you like to mention or bring up just to say, this is an up-and-coming player?
Mm-hmm. That's great. Yeah, we have a kid named Demetrius Hopkins. It was a coin toss to bring him. He's a 4.5 student.
Great.
He's a highly recruited kid. He's a great kid. He's always got a smile on his face, and no matter what is going on. And he's a wide receiver, defensive back. And He's just a, he's a one of those family atmosphere kids.
Yeah.
And Ramses Cesaris, he's our center, and he's another, you know, he's a brilliant kid, good-sized kid, and always smiling, been going through tough times right now. His grandfather just passed, and we took it as a family, you know, and it's, he's a family guy. He missed a game for a funeral in Mexico, and it was rough, you know, and he's back now, so.
That's great. But those sounds like you got a lot of heart on this team, and everybody's working good together. Coach Monica, it's been good having you on the show. Really appreciate you taking the time to be here. We're going to come right back with Game Time. We'll see you in a few minutes, okay? Stay tuned.
Too late for her.
Amy Tan's best-selling novel, The Joy Luck Club, comes to life this October. This story reveals the dynamics between mothers and daughters. Rendered with penetrating authenticity, raves the LA Weekly. Come out and enjoy an evening with family. The Joy Luck Club, on stage October 21st through October 23rd. Phil Vassar is coming to San Bernardino. For one night only, come and see one of America's greatest country artists perform his greatest hits, accompanied by his outstanding piano skills and his honest and heartfelt lyrics. All coming together with a touch of rhythm and blues. Phil Vassar, live at the California Theater, October 7th.
Welcome back to Game Time. Now, you just saw we talked with Coach Monica from San Bernardino, and we saw a little bit, some snippets of some of the San Bernardino guys in action, and they're here right now on the show, Mr. Eric Holloway and Khleem Perkins. How are you guys doing, fellas?
Great, and you?
Great.
Welcome to the show. Yes. Excited that you're here.
You guys ready to have some fun?
Yes.
All right, well, let's take you down a memory lane. You guys are playing high school ball now. You have big aspirations, but when did you decide you wanted to play football, and what made you have that passion to play this sport?
Well, it all started when I started watching my cousin play when he was at San Bernardino High School, Richard Morrell.
Okay.
And then it just motivated me to play, like all the action, the lights, the crowd, it was just fun to play.
Okay, and you're the quarterback, right?
Yes, ma'am.
You had a game last week.
Yes, I did.
Okay, and you're a linebacker as well?
Yes. No, safety.
Safety, okay. And what about you?
I'm running back and linebacker.
Okay. And you had about 16 tackles?
Yep.
Wow.
Hits.
Okay. What made you decide to play football?
It made me to start when I was watching NFL, just watching the lights and everything. And it was just making me feel like I was missing out on the action. Mm. I want a piece of it. That's so, yeah.
That's exciting stuff. Now, prior to the games, you got to get pumped up. I mean, football is a mental game as well as a physical game.
Yes,
what are some of the rituals that you guys incorporate prior to the game starting to make sure that you bring your A game?
Pray.
Mm, good.
Listen to music full blast in my headphones.
Yeah.
Zone them out.
Yeah. Nice. What artists are you listening to?
Lil Wayne, Drake, Tyga, doesn't matter.
Yeah. Just getting pumped up.
Yes.
That's exciting.
Lots of good chance stuff in the locker room.
Yep.
Yes.
You guys hyped?
A lot.
Well, both of you guys both play offense and defense. Yes. If you had to play just one side, what will it be? Eric?
Defense.
Okay. Why is that?
Hitting.
You like to hit?
Yes.
Okay. What about you, Khleem?
Offense, because I like to score. I like it to share the ball to everybody.
Last week, I believe over 300 yards you had.
Yes, ma'am.
Well done.
Now, Eric, are you middle linebacker, outside linebacker?
Outside linebacker.
Okay. Yeah. Gotcha. So just fly around there just hitting anything that moves, huh? Now, and Khleem, do you get to audible at the line at all? You get to change any
yes
plays up,
yes,
look at the defense and see what's going on
yes
there? That's good. So both of you guys, I mean, using a lot of instinct and, you know, I mean, there's some mental smarts that take place with all of this. If you guys could tell a younger player, let's say an eighth grader, seventh grader is watching this thing, about what do you need to do? What are some of the attributes that you need to have to be a great high school football player? What would you tell them?
stay disciplined in grades. Stay in school. Yes.
Tell us again what DWB stands for.
Do what you're supposed to do when you're supposed to do it to the best of your ability.
That's great. Absolutely. That's great. You got a good coach and coaching you up well.
Absolutely.
That's good.
Now speaking, you know, you have Coach Monica, but what are some, you know, professional athletes or NFL players that you model your game after?
Cam Newton.
Okay. Like that mobile quarterback.
Yes. Okay. He does it all.
Cam Newton. What about defensively?
Taylor Mays. Mm,
okay. All right. What about you, Eric?
Ray Lewis.
Just likes to hit.
And talk smack, too.
Yeah. Okay.
And back it up.
Back it up.
Yep.
That's you on the field, talking smack. And yeah.
Both sides of the ball.
Both sides.
Oh,
yep.
Boy.
What player offensively?
Probably Jenkins from Green Bay Packers.
Oh, okay.
Wide receiver.
Okay.
You guys have picked some good ones, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Well, as you know, you guys are student athletes, and the student always comes before the athlete.
Yes, sir.
What are you guys looking at in terms of your future plans, in terms of where you're going to be going to college? And speaking of college, I mean, this is just a slew.
Well, you look at that.
I mean, look at, these are all the letters that you're getting from these big schools and everything. Alabama,
UCLA,
UNLV.
Florida State.
I'm looking right here at the reigning national champ, Auburn Tigers, right here, right into you guys saying, hey, we think you got some potential. We want you to come to our school. What are you guys thinking about for the future? What's college look like? Would you like to play football at the college level? What's that all about? Yeah. Where would you like to go?
Boise
State?
Yes.
Yeah, nice.
Probably Auburn.
Yeah?
Yeah,
that wouldn't be a bad choice, huh? Yeah, both of you guys. You know, who knows? You guys could be playing against each other in a national championship if that all turned out, huh?
Yeah.
That'd be sweet. What do you have to do physically to get ready for college football? What step do you need to take to make that
hit
jump?
Hit the weights.
Yeah.
Yep. Weight room.
Mm. You feel like you guys are doing that at the level you need to now, or is that something you wait till the offseason to start?
I've been doing it a little bit now.
Hit the 50.
Yeah.
Gotcha. And what year are you guys in school?
I'm a junior.
I'm a sophomore.
Okay, so we got some time.
Absolutely.
Right. That's great.
Speaking of time being of the essence, next week you play a very strong school, San Andreas Lee, you know, Cajon.
Yes.
Talk to me, fellas. What's the game plan? Eric, what are you going to do to help the team get a victory?
Work hard. Got to get a couple of flags to win.
Okay.
So calling out off the field, leave it all on the field. That's all you have to do.
That's right. Khleem, what about you?
Just make smart pass plays, try to help my team win as much as I can. Mm.
And what did you guys learn from last week's game against Palm Desert? I mean, you guys fought, you know, and a couple of penalties kind of threw it in the other direction. We don't want to blame the refs or anything like that, but what did you learn from that you're going to take into this next game?
Cut down on the mistakes. We can be a lot better.
Nice. Yeah. Well, there you go. It's all mental.
Yeah.
We believe in you guys. And just want to thank you guys for coming on the show and being a part of this thing. And we wish you luck this week.
All right.
Thank you for having us.
Good deal.
And we'll be right back after these messages on Game Time.
We'll see you on Game Time.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for watching Game Time. As we bring you the community of gifted student athletes from all around the San Andreas League.
And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we introduce our first of two student athlete profiles. Let's take a look at Brandon Bennett from Rialto High School.
My name is Brandon Bennett. I'm a senior. I go to Rialto High School. I play DB and running back, but most likely I'm pursuing DB so I can go to college, but DB, you gotta work on your mechanics, on footwork and stuff. You gotta like always have good hip work, feet work. You always gotta train. Hand placement, where you got the gym, wide receiver, wherever you're going. I started playing at age 7. I got involved because my dad pushed me to play. And then I ended up playing because my older brother played. So I was like, yeah, I should play. It's like a family sport thing. So I was like, yeah, it's sport for me. Practice, we do warm-ups, like early outs, go over plays before we do, and like stretch. My favorite part is when we do one-on-ones with our tiers. That's my favorite part. I like doing that. My teammates, everybody on there strive for excellence. Like, we try not to pit each other down. We don't like doing that. We always expect like high expectations for each other. We always be there. Our teammates, we tell everybody like show for practice. We don't want no missed practices. If you miss, like, that's a letdown. We don't want that on the team. We want everybody here to be on time, doing what they gotta do, work hard in the weight room, on the field, in class, for as a team, as a family. I've been playing on the Coach Show for 3 years. Coach Show, he's a good coach. He teaches you everything, fundamentals, how to grow as a man, mature.
Brandon Bennett is an outstanding football player. He's been a 3-year starter here for us at Rialto High School. Each year, showing a lot of growth in all areas, not just on the football field. As a young man, he's really come out of his shell the last couple years. A silent team leader. I think because of his silence, people understand his worth to our football team and to our defense, and we expect a lot of explosive things out of him this year.
My biggest influence is my older brother. I like everything he do and stuff, so I always want to be just like him, but like, all the time when he tell me, like, I want you to be better than me, so I was like, yeah, that's my goal, to be better than him. And he always wanted that for me, and like, always strive for the best.
And Rialto is off to a really good start. They're 2-1. Good luck to Brandon and the Knights as they start league play next week.
Yeah, all right. And now let's take a look at the Lady Knights profile with Miranda Martinez.
My name is Miranda Martinez. I go to Rialto High School, and I'm a senior. The sport I'm involved in right now is cross country. I think the most difficult part about cross country is probably the mental part of it, because you're going to be tired, but then you just have to keep reminding yourself, keep going, and I think that's the biggest part, overcoming that. Oh, my favorite part? Racing. Because, you know, just getting out there and putting it to the test, seeing how hard you trained, seeing if it all is gonna pay off. My teammates, we're like sisters. We're all best friends, because not only do we hang out here at practice, but we hang out at school too. And we're like a big family, and we really work hard together, because if someone's feeling down, we understand that if they're feeling down, they can't keep up, then they'll tell us. And if they're having a good day, we look really strong when we're running together. So together, we're a good group. For practice, we get tortured. We get put to 7 to 8 mile runs. We do sandy hills, not even hills, more like mountain hills. Like, it's really work, but we get through it. Coach Marie has been someone that's always been there for me. She's someone I really look up to for motivation. And she's always been there for me since my freshman year, even not when I was in soccer. I could always go to her. And she's someone I could easily talk to. And when I hear her at races cheering for me, that's just so much motivation to keep going. And I can honestly say that Coach Marie has been the reason I kept coming back, like, definitely.
Miranda's run for us for 4 years. She's one of the hardest working athletes that we've had come through the program. She's always working hard. When she comes in, you can tell she's given it all. You know, when she comes and finishes her workout, she's given 100%. She doesn't go around messing around, you know, ditching the workouts or anything. She'll come and she'll give it all her effort.
I like to give thanks to, of course, God, Coach Marie, my parents for always being there to support me through my injuries and just keeping me going with everything I do. And to my teammates, definitely, for being there for me through the hard times.
That was a fantastic profile. Cross country is definitely not for the faint of heart. Good luck to the entire Rialto cross country team. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that takes us to our matchup of the week. It's going to take place next week at the Cajon Cowboys football team stadium, and they're going against San Bernardino High School. That's going to be a really good week. Don't forget, we look out for Corey Sandoval, his sightings. That's going to be hilarious. Don't forget to follow Corey on Twitter at GameTimeSB. And you'll see the latest clips of our Facebook page, which is facebook.com/GameTime.
There you go. We also want to remind all of you watching the show that we will be off next week with our return on Tuesday, October 4th. We'll be back with the start of the San Andreas League games, so don't miss it. I'm Mark Hartley.
And I'm Jasmine George. And you've been watching Game Time.
Yes.